Welcome to GrayYeon Math. We are asked to solve this problem. We are given a regular hexagon divided into three parts. The dark green area is 2 square units and the yellow area is 1 square unit. And we are required to find the green area. But before we go to the solution, may I request you to please like the video and subscribe to the channel. And you can pause for a moment if you have any solutions about this problem. Please write it on the comment section. Okay, so first thing that we need to do is we need to draw lines that will divide this hexagon into 6 equal parts. So if we draw a line from here to here, then this is congruent to this triangle. And if we draw a line from this point to this point, and we draw a line parallel to the topmost part, and again we draw a line parallel from this point that is parallel to this side, and a line that is parallel to this side. So, we divide this regular hexagon into 6 equal parts. And we can say that these areas, we call that as 80, 80, 80, 80, 80, 80. And these are 6 portions. So, we have area of the hexagon is equal to 680. Okay, so now that we know that this hexagon can be divided into 6 equal parts, and we now focus on the dark green portion and the yellow portion and remove the lines that we are not needing. Okay, so next thing that you need to do is you need to focus on this dark green region and that this small right triangle form. So if we say that the base can be labeled as B, and this red line is actually divisible into 2 equal parts. So if this is H, then this is H also. Okay. And the formula for this triangle would be 1/2 times the base times 2h, and that is AE1. So AE1 is equal to BH. And next is AE2. For AE2, we have actually only the height is H and of the same base. And so AE2 is equal to 1/2 times the base times the height. So AE2 equal to 1/2 BH. So if we compare these two triangles in terms of area, we have area E1 is equal to BH. If we divide this, and area E2, we have 1/2 BH, then BH simply cancels out. Then we have 1/1/2 is 2, and area E1 over area E2, and therefore we can say that area E1 is equal to times area U2. Okay, so next thing that we need to do is we need to focus on this dark green region. This dark green region is given with the area of 2 square units. And it is equal to the area T plus this area 1, this small triangle. We need to add this, but this small triangle area E1 is actually equal to 2 times area E2. So we have now our first equation. Okay, so next thing that we have to do is we need to focus on this yellow region. The yellow region has an area of 1 square unit, and this 1 square unit is actually area P, which is this area, these two lines, and this red line, the triangle that they form, area P. But you need to subtract this area E2. You need to subtract that to form the yellow region, which is 1 square unit. So we have to subtract area E2, and this will be our equation T. Okay, so next thing that we need to do is we need to use these two equations to solve for area AT. So if we try to multiply this equation 2 by 2, and we copy the first equation. And now if we add these two equations, then this cancels out. Then we have 4 is equal to 3 times 18. But 18 will be equal to 4 thirds square units. Okay, so next thing that we need to observe is that the area of this green region is actually equal to the area of the hexagon minus the area of the dark green region minus the area of this yellow region. But the hexagon has an area of 6 times 80, because this regular hexagon can be divided into 6 equal parts, minus the area of this dark green region, which is 2, and this area of this yellow region is 1, equal to the area of the green. So area of the green is equal to 6 times, but the area of this 80 triangle is equal to 0 thirds minus 3. So if we simplify this, this becomes 2 times 4, 8 minus 3 is equal to 5. So area of the green region is equal to 5 square units. And that is our answer. Please comment down below if you have any other solutions for this problem. So thank you for watching until the end of the video. Please like the video if you like our solution. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you will be updated for more math videos like this. Thank you. Bye.